So what do you do when you finally realize this just isn't worth it?
I know, it's okay. You'll be back in the air shortly. It'll be all right. It won't be that long.
So the last 3 weeks have been nothing but research and digging and clicking and calling into the actual prospect of upgrading 2214 Yankee to a Lycoming 0360. And at the end of my three-week research project, calling dozens of people, dozens of engine shops, calling everyone I could think of who has anything to do with this, spending countless hours online, and talking to everyone who I could possibly think of who had any expertise in this subject, I've come down to this final conclusion. It just isn't worth it. Although it would seem awesome and a really cool thing to do to upgrade this engine to an 0360, there are several roadblocks and obstacles that popped out at me right from the start. And I didn't even know that these were there unless you're an aircraft mechanic and a longtime Cardinal owner. And you wouldn't know that these landmines were there either. So let's count them off. Number one, we'll start with the STC. To do an upgrade like this, you have to start with an STC or a supplemental type certificate. And there are only two of these available for this particular upgrade, and you have to buy them. They're documents, and basically you can look at them as certified instruction manuals that legalize and license the process of the upgrade. They permit the airframe to be upgraded to this particular engine. However, the STCs that I needed were simply not available. I only found two. And one was just not available, the people who owned it just weren't available. And the other was questionable, and I couldn't verify the STC's legitimacy. And you don't want to go ahead with a huge project like this with an illegit STC. Then the whole thing is done under a false STC, and if you're putting in this kind of money, you're in big trouble because basically your airplane and the upgrade and all that money you spent is worthless. Number two, let's look at the actual benefits that I'm getting from this upgrade. If I do an upgrade to a larger engine, will my performance increase, and will my top speed increase, and will my useful load increase? Well, the answer is no, a little bit, and not really. You really have to look at the benefits that you're gonna get from an upgrade, and also you're gonna have to look at the benefits that you will get from an investment around $50,000. And yes, that brings me to number three, the cost. Pricing this all out would be slightly north of $50,000, and that's just not worth it to put into the airplane. It's just not wise. Basically, everything forward of the firewall needs to be replaced, and I was dealing with a fixed pitch prop, not a constant speed prop. If I was dealing with a constant speed prop, then I'm going to be adding another $10,000 to $15,000 onto that, and the dozens of other little modifications that you just don't know you're going to have to do until you get in there and start pulling things apart. This is a 1968 airplane, and a lot has changed since then. So you have to really look at the costs once you get in there, and at the end of the day, it just isn't financially wise. It isn't worth it. And you have to weigh that against how bad do you want a new engine. It may be wiser just to go ahead and get a new airplane altogether. I didn't want to do that. I want to keep 2214 Yankee because I really like the airplane. Number four, you have to ask yourself, what is the wisest thing to do in this situation? Whenever you have a difficult decision to make, that is the first question to ask. What is the wisest thing to do? For me, the wisest thing to do was put a freshly overhauled Lycoming 0320 back in this aircraft. This would not require any new STCs. I can use all my old parts, all my old exhaust. I can use my old power flow, and there are no surprises. I know everything's gonna fit. I can use the same oil cooler, the same starter. Also, this would free me up budget-wise to put a new engine monitor in, which would greatly help the management of this new engine, which is a must-have. Also, this freed me up budget-wise to put a new interior in, and since this was timed out with Sun and Fun, I was able to get a fantastic deal on a JPI EDM 900. I got that for like $3,800, which is a really good price, and I got a new interior from AirTex Interiors. So, honestly, up to this point, I feel the hardest part of this equation was making this decision to stick with the 0320. It is the wisest thing to do. Also, this is gonna be manageable as far as the actual project. There's gonna be fewer surprises, and it will meet my expectations. We know what's going out, we know what's coming in, and also it'll be done in a decent time frame. The only bad part is that the lead time on this is between 5 and 7 weeks. All in all, that's about average. So today I pulled the trigger on a new engine and it should be delivered in about 5 weeks. Next week, I'm gonna have my engine removed and I'm gonna drop it off at Airmark Engines in Fort Lauderdale. So I'll put up a couple of posts about that. And then let's jump into that new interior. So I wanna thank you for watching. I'll keep you informed as the progress and the journey through this project goes. So thanks again for watching. If you're over 50, you know what to do, and